So far, I haven't diagnosed myself or been diagnosed with psychopathology. Creativity by itself is not normal. I could be your imaginary friend. My name is Joe Davis, and I'm officially designated as artist scientist at George Church's lab at Harvard Medical School in Harvard Genetics.
He is a very creative interdisciplinary scientist pretending to be an artist. A lot of what passes for true science is quite incremental and doesn't really change things. Joe, on the other hand, is more likely to contribute to transformative science than that's what my lab is all about.
As new tools and new knowledge become available in the world of science and technology, they also become available to art. The criticisms were, Joe Davis thinks the laboratory is a playground. Well, yes, I think the laboratory is a playground. It's amazing. These are my DNA prayer flags. This is a horn coral. This is a crystal radio. And of course, Joe Davis special release primordial soup. I have no scientific credential whatsoever. I like to put these, to create these situations where the two opposites, so-called opposites, are merged in such a way that they can't be discriminated. That is the greatest thrill of all, you know? That's the great unification of knowledge. We recently realized this three-year project to get silk moths to spin silk that could metallize with metallic gold. Mariko Kasi and I created the first biometallized silk in the last several weeks. You know, creativity is the ability to put things together in new ways. These same materials can be used to take up heavy metals from contaminated groundwaters at terrible sites like Fukushima. Art helps science understand itself.
So why don't people feed artists?
Why don't they feed artists they feed scientists? Mm-hmm. I hope that by my example, society, not just science, will realize the value of what people like me can do, and that eventually they will be paid to do these things. They certainly deserve to be paid to do these things, but somebody has to show them the way. And if nobody does, then they'll never get paid. So here we go. You got $5. In this dictionary, it says art is human effort to imitate, supplement, alter, or counteract the work of nature.
Joe may or may not deliver the ideas directly, but he causes us to think differently.
Over the last 25 years, I invented various DNA programming languages to allow me to insert information into organisms that's not biological information, but rather human intellectual information. This suggests a world in which the whole terrestrial biome is the message board. Techniques for improving the information handling capacity of DNA are right now being created with the potential to replace the internet. Ideally, we could put all this information into everything that's around us. Everything could be there and could never be burned. Art is always been involved with this struggle against the harsh forces of nature to hold on to the legacy and the dreams of culture. I think most of the problems that humanity has these days is that we're all expected to do just one thing. We go to work one way on the way to work. We go the same way to work every day. We sit in the same cubicle or the same office and do the same thing day in and day out. I have great adventures. You only have one chance in this world to make it a better place, and often that involves a great adventure. Without them, life would probably be basically unbearable.
You see that light?
Yeah.
That's the spectra of a G-type star.
What's that?
It's a incredible thermonuclear reaction with enormous violence. It's going on at this minute 93 million miles away.
And how does that make you feel?
Alive.
In your life, you gotta have time for work, and you have to have time for life. You can't have only work, and you can't have only life, because this, either way, it's self-destructive. You have to stop on both sides and make time for the other.
Land of Fremont, I bid ye farewell. We're bound out for Greenland and ready to sail in hopes to find riches and hunting the whales.